Now, in this session, I wanted to show one of the other little things that may be of some value when you're doing a paint job. What I have this is the helmet. We've got three coats of clear on it now, and it's loaded with imperfections because this is something that's really been in rough shape. And I wanted to show this. I've done some of the sanding here. You can see the low spots, some of the spots where this helmet was damaged. And I didn't want to put any Bondo on the helmet, that's for sure. Some of the scratches. But what I wanted to show by doing this little project, and you can see it hasn't been sanded here. Let's take a spot. There's two things we can do here. I'm going to use 320 paper, some soapy water, pick any spot you want, shiny spot, and I'm going to try to just do some sanding until as many of the low spots as practical go away. Now, I really can't get them all to go away, but I can get probably 80-90% of them to go away. Now, in the past, what I've done is I've used 600 sandpaper, 1200, and then I started getting, so I said, well, wait, I have some 500, I had some 600, I said, well, let me go in the other direction, because I'm going to put a lot more clear on this helmet. And what I'm really using the clear for now is just pretty much to seal in the finish that we have, the green. And by the way, the green and the purple both, or blue, whatever color you want to call it, they seem to really get a lot nicer with that last couple of coats of clear. So what I'm going to do is sand this all down. We can't do any painting today, it's snowing. So this would be a good project. Get as much of the sanding done as I possibly can. The one thing not to do, and I've learned this the hard way, may as well show this. My hard block, I've done this in the past thinking, well, I can get rid of that edge, the paint edge where it changes color, and I'd grind away at it. Not a good idea. It's better to do it either with a soft block, the rubber that's a little spongy. Definitely don't want to do that with the hard block. In fact, I can't even do it. The paper isn't big enough. But I'd want to go on that edge, but not with a hard block. But in this case, I like doing it by hand. I just like doing it. It's kind of an old school feeling. And get as much of this flattened out as I can. Again, with sandpaper this rough, you're absolutely, definitely not going to buff this out. This has to have another coat of clear. When the weather's appropriate, to spray some clear. And in our case, you never know if that's ever going to come. We just got one little snow issue after another one here. But now even Luciano, who at one time in his life was a professional bodyman, was surprised that I was using 320 paper at this point in the game. But when I showed him the final result, he was a believer. So a lot of people would be skeptical of using that rough of a paper. But the results, it's a funny thing with bodywork. A lot of people think if you have a $1 million spray booth and a $300 spray gun and all this expensive stuff, that the result will be that you'll have this beautiful paintwork. And I don't know where that comes from. It's like I've always said, if I was to put on a professional football player's uniform, you wouldn't be scoring a touchdown, that's for sure. Or in Karen's case, she goes to art lessons, and if you have an expensive paintbrush, it doesn't mean you're going to be a good artist. Where it comes from is the technique of using it. Now, in my case, I'm constantly experimenting. I never just do the same thing twice. I'm always looking for some way to make it a little bit better or nicer or whatever. Now, just as an example, I just want to get this clean. Now, I've got my little area that I was working on up here flat. All I need to do at this point is get it flat. Where it's shiny, there's still little imperfections in here. I'm going to work them. And I might even, because of this helmet, now, let me backtrack. What I originally thought about doing was I was going to take this helmet and maybe send it out to Arai and get all new guts inside of it. And I thought, I'm not going to spend a couple of $100 for that. That's just not going to happen. So I decided I wanted to just make a keeper helmet. And I had this paint left over, but I didn't want to take the helmet itself. And I didn't want to do a lot of Bondo work. And I wanted to try another technique. And the technique was to try to, is exactly what I'm doing. Because most of the damage was small, I wanted to try doing it with both the clear coats, and hopefully this will look, when I'm done, it'll look real nice. Of course, the proof is always in the pudding. And a lot of times, I watch one of the car shows, it doesn't matter who it is, Chip Foose or, whoever, and I can't see their vision right in the beginning, but they're doing something. And then at the end of the show, you see what, wow, that looks pretty cool. Well, a lot of times it's like with the paintwork is the same thing. You're working, and all of a sudden, it has a much different look than when you started. So anyway, not gonna make a big deal out of this, but I wanted to show that at this step, after two thick coats of clear, and we've let it dry a couple of days up by a heating vent, we still have little imperfections. So what I'll probably do is put on two more coats of clear, let that dry a week or so, a couple of days anyway. Because again, in the cold weather, the paint dries slow. In warm weather, if we were in the middle of the summer, we could be doing a coat every 2 hours, but let me get a fresh towel on this and just show it. And never think for a minute that, like, the mistake with all the paintwork is to think there's one way to do it. See, this is always the mistake. You think you're gonna sand it with this grit paper and then Bondo it and then put this filler and then one coat of this and three coats of that. That's not it at all. It's kind of like making soup. You gotta get in there and, that needs to be a little more level. There would be a lot of ways to do this, and one way would have been to fill in all these things with Bondo, but I have a feeling when the helmet is done and you see that the technique that I'm showing here, I think when you look at the helmet, you're not going to ever see that it isn't perfect. I'm kind of confident of that because I've done it before. In fact, I'm cocky. I know you're saying that. So, but anyway, as I always try to do at the end of every little video, just my personal, let's see if we can get under the light here. See if you can start to identify what the little errors are. These are things that, if doing it another way, here's some of the stuff, that little area. All that stuff is going to go away in the final finish. Now, up here, we still have the paint edge. I can feel that paint edge with my bare hand, but that's going to go away. And eventually, the whole helmet is going to look like that after sanding. And again, what I do, I take a whole sheet, and this is paint that didn't come from a body shop. This came from Lowe's, but it's just as good. But it is 320. I cut up a whole sheet because that's probably what I'll use. In fact, there's the numbers, the 320 numbers. A little bit of soapy water, a little bit of elbow grease, and before we pack it up here, I wanted to show them that this is my little. Luciano was here today, and he kind of looked over everything, gave it his approval. A little carbon fiber part that we made to cover that up. That kind of came out nice. And the pride and joy of the fleet here. The tank has the gas cap on now. It's ready. We're going to go buy some new fuel line. That really, I think it came out nice. The tail section came out really, really nice. John Pothia did a great job with the decaling. And sometime later this week, Najat is going to be here to do some painting. So we're going to try to put some more stuff on the video and just show a little progress report at the end of each day. But this is one of the things that I kind of like is a job like this, it unfolds a little bit each day. And you see progress pretty much every day. In fact, where are the fairings here? The fairings are drying up. You notice they're under a heating vent over there. They're drying up. They'll be ready for a sand out in a day or two. I think once we get done with all of the parts on this, we're just going to have ourselves a nice little project bike for the upcoming year for track days. Anyway, my email address is windyu@AOL, and you can subscribe to the channel windy_u. Either way, I hope you enjoyed the video and some of the little things, little tips I've tried to put on from time to time.